windfall for this agreement will be so dramatic. When will you look at the, at the economic situation of Iran? You ask yourself, why did they choose to have these negotiations and to conclude this agreement? Which, to some extent, is limiting quite dramatically Iranian sovereignty. Iran accepted limitation on its nuclear program that no other state in the world accepted. As I say, states were accepted to agree to do it when they were forced militarily. But no other state that I am aware of agreed to do it diplomatically. They did it because of their terrible economic situation. And this terrible economic situation is threatening the survival of the regime. And it doesn't matter what political leaders are saying. In real life, their first goal is the political survival. Everything else comes after that. So they have to invest in their political survival. And you don't do it by having these very essential funds that they need for their economy and for the welfare of the people, to get the support of the people, by pouring all this money on Hezbollah. So Hezbollah and Bashar Assad and others will get their share. They were always quite high priority. And they got what they needed. So now they will get a little bit more. It doesn't change the taste of the soup. It's the same soup. So the important issue now is to sit together, the United States, with its European allies, with its Middle Eastern allies, with Israel, and devise ways to deal with these malicious actions of Iran. And it's quite possible. In contrast with the very common perception that Iran is 10 feet tall and it goes from a success to another success, I think reality is quite different. It's possible to contain Iran. And these days we are seeing it. Iran is contained in Yemen. Its proxy, the Houthis, are now rolled back and defeated. Iran is contained in Syria. The Bashar al-Assad regime is not having the upper end with all the support that they are getting from Iran. They are actually under existential threat, and the situation of the regime is getting worse and worse with all the support of Iran. And I really believe that we can this coalition, anti-Iranian coalition, could make their life much more miserable. But the last point that I wanted to make is that, as I said, probably Iran is not going to change. But when I say it, I refer mostly to the short term and the medium. In the longer term, Iran can change. And it is quite possible that in 10, 20, 30 years, I don't know how much time, we will look backward, those of us that will still survive, and we say, well, this agreement was a beginning. But I believe it will be a very slow and timely process. Which is possible because we know that in Iran there are many people, maybe the majority of the people, that want Iran to be a normal member of the international community.